The deal brings together the National Police, Immigration Department, Revenue Authority, CAFIS, Port Health and the Tourism Department. It's aimed to improve efficiency and transparency at Kenya's main port of entry. And with it, the government talked tough.
It will not be business as usual. Every 11 visitors who come into this country create a job to a Kenyan. You must be facilitative to make a client feel he's welcome into the country.
If you're working in customs, when you obstruct fellow Kenyans who are coming back into the country and make it look like it's a crime to travel, you are hurting our country. When you frustrate a visitor, when you speak rudely to a visitor, when you take forever to assist people, you are hurting our country.
If this service charter does not succeed, the repercussions will be severe, including commercial outcomes. We shall outsource the services of this airport.
The charter identifies gaps experienced by passengers at JKIA as well as other airports as mainly consisting of lack of coordination among agencies, delays and queues during peak operating hours, especially at customs and immigration desks, poor customer services and bribery, among others.
Johnny, you must deliver. We would not like to take excuses. We must hire an airport manager now, conduct a competitive exercise, open, transparent, focused, get a competent person to run this airport as an airport manager. Let us get the work done.
As part of the process, Kenya Airports Authority is expected to deliver a progress report every 3 months to line ministries, aside from weekly monitoring meetings.
It's a lot about resource allocation, you know, having the right people, the right number of people at the right time throughout the different contact points of the airport when you are moving through the airport.
As part of the charter, two airlines have already had part of their aircraft fleets grounded for illegal conversion of passenger aircraft to cargo. While the government concealed the identity of the airlines, Citizen Television has learned that the two airlines are in the Miraa freight business.
Through this airport service charter, the government is keen on ensuring that the Jomo Kenyatta International Airport is able to offer world-class services in the next 90 days. This ahead of Kenya Airways' inaugural flight to the United States on October 28th. Mombi Warowe, Citizen TV.